I do, folks. This here's the old mountain man talking at you from the backside of this here lake in the hills of Arkansas. Well, I just watched a video a little while ago about a young lady that was trying to build a fire with a magnesium bar fire starter, and she had to go get a cotton ball. She had some grass out there. Well, as you can hear, somebody out there is shooting their damn guns. Well, as I said in the previous video, everybody's always wanting to get their noise in whenever I'm trying to shoot a damn video. Well, let's get back on with the subject. Let's get back here on my equipment chain. Now, what she was using and what she didn't realize was, there's a sparking insert. She was thinking this was a handle back here. That's your magnesium bar. You scrape off some of that magnesium with a pocket knife or a razor blade. I like to use a box blade, and that's an old rusty one, but doesn't really matter when it comes to a box blade. Now, let's see here what we got. Got that little pan that I'd used. This is something I build fires in during wet weather. Get a little bit of tinder in there. That stuff over there. Get some dry oak leaves. Them all crumbled up. And it ain't wet weather today. Let's see. I'll just use this one since they're both basically the same. Just scrape it off on there. Get be better get it there on top. Get your magnesium shavings going in a nice little pile. I don't know how them people knew I was gonna be shooting video. They sure started shooting their damn guns. Maybe they got a drone. One of them handy dandy little gadgets they fly around and dick off with. They seen I was about to start shooting a video or something. I don't know. Well, that went over like a fart in an elevator, didn't it? Could be I should use some dry grass, and I'll bet you, I see some. Well, daggum. Dry leaves and magnesium. Should've worked. We'll get some dry grass. Alright. This right here. It's what's called sage grass. Anybody ever seen a field full of sage grass go up? That stuff goes up like gasoline. Now, kind of wander around here a little bit. We'll get some young sage grass. A little bit shorter there on the bottom. Well, you couldn't really tell the difference, could you? Little bear quit it. Quit, park knocker. Dog of mine, he's a mess. See, fire building, it doesn't always go the way these edited videos go on YouTube. I mean, there's a bunch of them out there. They'll screw around and they'll edit their videos and make it look like it happens every single time perfectly. You know, all the time. That's bullshit. So there's no need for anybody to feel bad if they don't get fire going the first time. You didn't see me chewing myself out because I didn't get going first time. I was just about confident that those dry leaves would touch off with that magnesium. Of course, and that magnesium went up just the way I figured it would, but well, what do you know? There's an old cotton swab in there. Well, we'll just pull the I use cotton swabs for a lot of things, including cleaning firearms, and I always do that outside. And speaking of firearm cleaning and whatnot, we got some gun oil, just regular old Outers gun oil, put in a little tube and a little applicator. So you got the little needle type tube applicator. Yeah, just a little bit of, just a few drops. I set that grass aside whenever I stumbled upon that cotton swab. Now you can use any kind of oil. You can use cooking oil, machine oil, gun oil, animal fat. As long as it's oil or some type of grease, you can get it on the cotton. And that's just, as I said before, I didn't saturate all of the cotton. I got some on the backside there. Some of the cotton is not saturated in order for it to take a spark. Now, let me see here. I got a different ferro rod or fire starting rod here. Ferrocerium, ferro rod, fire steel, whatever you call it, it's all the same damn thing. And this is the smallest size that I've got. And I've been using one of these for years. Years! Yeah. Take a look. That one on the bottom, or closest to the bottom there. That's the one I've been using for years. There's just not much difference in the wear on it. And it's almost worn completely around. And there it is. And it's got the little ridges on it, which is gonna happen. You can't stop it. No matter if you just scrape it. It don't matter if you just scrape it or hit or whatever. I don't suggest hitting, you know, doing like this, like you're trying to strike a piece of flint with steel. No. No. Don't do that. Just scrape it. And alright, let me get this around here where you can see. Alright. Put your striker down there close to your tender and pull the rod. Let's see if we can get that. That might catch after a little bit. I don't know. Alright, another thing about these fire starting rods. I see people start out with them and they're over here, I can't get a spark, I can't get a spark. It's because you got a coating on there. Gotta get that coating off. See that little streak? Get that coating off of there every time. Now get that coating off of there, and you scrape it as many times as you need to get that coating off. Get a good patch of that coating wore off of there, about like that. About like that right there, and you see there's already little dents in that. That's because the cerium is one of the softest metals in the ferrocerium rod. Yeah. See, there's a little notch right there and there and there. It's going to happen. You can't avoid it. Let's go back to the cotton here. Now, get a good stream of sparks going off of that thing. Now, get your striker down there close to it. Pull the dang rod. There it goes. Right there. You got your radiant flame. Most people need that radiant flame to be going like that to kind of help build their confidence in fire building. If you don't have that radiant flame, you know, just within a little bit, then by golly, it just kind of discourages people. So I encourage people, however you need to do it, you know, use a little bit of oil, animal fat, vegetable oil, whatever. And yeah, if I had see, that's the good thing about oak leaves. They're made out of wood too. Just thinner. And you can keep on piling them on there. And even if it goes out, you still got that hot spot down in there. You know, you get a tiny little bit of oak leaves going, you get them going, get them caught on fire and get them going. You still got that little hot spot down in there that you can blow. And get that fire built back up, which will give you time to get little stuff like this. This little stick right here, of course, I just picked this up off the ground. It's one of my old chopsticks. And I feel like I have to reiterate, it is not gonna go perfect every single time, all the time. These bozos on YouTube that edit their damn videos and make it look so damn easy are just looking for views and admiration, look for people to blow smoke up their ass and say, oh man, that was great, that was perfect, yeah. And then people go out and they buy these fire building rods and what have you, and they expect to do the exact same thing as what was shown in that edited video. It doesn't work that way all the time. See, it might have looked like ashes, but yeah, you got unburnt material down in there. Those leaves, it'll take a long time for them to turn to ashes, and until it's all gray ashes, you still be able to get flame out of them, which would give you time to get little bitty twigs, a little bitty this and that, little toothpick size stuff, and slowly build the fire. You don't just go out and start a fire. I mean, if you want to start a fire, get yourself a couple ounces of gasoline and some leaves and throw a match to it and start a fire. What I do is fire building. Yeah, I'm not against somebody carrying a little Visine bottle full of, let's say, lighter fluid. Something that's not real flammable, but flammable enough. And then, you know, whenever you use the cotton ball and the oil or whatever lubricant, you know, that you choose to use, then that right there is going to help build your confidence, as I said before, and then you move up to things like this char path. Now, this is where the grass comes in. Alright? I want to see about... What's the matter, little brother? Is that gunfire spooking you, buddy? Huh? What's the matter? You need some comfort in, huh? What's the matter, buddy? Is that gunfire spooking you? He doesn't like gunfire unless I'm the one doing the shooting. Then he knows food's gonna be on the table. He starts getting all excited. Go on over and lay down somewhere. Come on. Come on. Gotta give me some elbow room here, pal. Just a little piece of char cloth there. Come on, little bear. Get back. Gotta have some room. I know you're skittish and you're scared, but I'm busy. I can't help the way events unfolded here. Now, bring this around here. Boy, that looks good right there. Yeah, you know the better it looks, the more it's going to screw up, don't you? Huh? Yeah. All right. We're going, instead of me scraping and knocking around on that, I'm going to put the tip of this blade down here as close as I can get it, and then I'm just going to use the tip of that fire starting rod. Let's see, we use about that much of it right there on the end. It is possible to keep it tapered. Alright. Boy, by golly, that worked out just great. Oh, look at there. See, but the bad thing is, with sage grass, it burns up real quick. But pretty much like oak leaves, it keeps a hot spot. So, there you have it. I don't know why I didn't shoot this video before. Took about, you know, almost 20 minutes. It's 19 minutes and 4 seconds now to kind of demonstrate some things, but I think it's well worth it and may just help somebody. And if you need a fire building kit, let me know. If all you want is a fire starting rod, I got them. Let's see, I got a price list, and you can hit me up at the business email address there on my channel. Of course, all you got to do is, see, you go to the About section. I can post the link to the About section in the video description below, and you just kind of look down there below where I talk about myself and my mentors and what I do, and look down there and then you'll see the line that reads for business inquiries, and then click to view email address. You solve that little scrambled word puzzle, little CAPTCHA puzzle. You copy down the email address on a piece of paper. You go to your email and you write me an email message for price list. Just put price list in the subject line. Ask me for a price list. I'll send it to you. You can figure out what you want. And, you know, those prices are not carved in stone. We can work something out if you can't afford it. If you can't afford the prices, of course, then again, I've been told that my prices are set too low anyway for handmade items. And I don't sell the orange handle fire steels anymore because people just didn't want them. They want the handmade stuff. But I've been working on the brass shell casings, 30-30 British 303 caliber shell casings with this size here, you know, the smaller size in them. And in time, I can find a larger caliber that'll fit the 3/8. And if I can find some 50 caliber brass shell casings, I can put those old big ones in there, the big 5-inch by 1/2-inch thick ones. And I've still got some of this magnesium left. This has been with me a long time. I'm waiting on a resupply, but my brother hadn't shown up. And if my brother sees this, please show up. You know, I'm always here. You don't got to worry about showing up and me not being here. I've got people waiting to place an order, and I really don't feel comfortable taking their money and have them wait on whatever. So I told them, hang on to your money, wait for me to get the resupply, then I can fill your order. You know, I'm far be it for me to take somebody's money and make them wait on what they're ordering. So with all the demonstrating done with, and as it's been said here on YouTube, with that being said, I remember Mark D. Chandler, he said, you know, people been saying with that being said a whole lot here on YouTube. Oh, well. With that being said, this here's the old mountain man signing off from the backside of this here lake in the hills of Arkansas, wishing y'all all the best. Goodbye, good luck, adios, sayonara. Talk with y'all later, take care of yourselves. And if you can't be good at it.